Hi, my name is Andrew Muir, and I'm at Duke University in Durham, North Carolina. So I was asked to give you a pearl about hepatitis C today. And so here I sit in September 2014, and we're days and weeks away from the release of even more great new medications for hepatitis C. And so we're in this new reality where almost all patients have highly effective, well-tolerated regimens for hepatitis C. And we know we can cure almost everyone. So, but the reality is that all patients are going to get their treatment right away for a number of reasons. And so I think we need to come back to the natural history and make sure they understand that and feel comfortable where they are with their liver disease and what's going to happen to them. I say this because I've talked to a number of patients now who've had hepatitis C for a number of years, but it almost seems that now that they know that there's these effective treatments away, they're even more stressed about getting treated as soon as possible. I think somehow they were able to put it to the side a little bit, but now that they know they can be cured, they want to get this as soon as possible. And so if your patient's not going to get treatment soon, whether it's because of access to coverage or maybe their payer is not covering their stage of disease or whatever it is, they just need to remember that this is a slow disease. It plays out over years. And while we're trying to get them treatment, and we will work as hard as we can to get that treatment for them, they need to be doing all they can to impact that natural history. So we know other factors matter. So if you're overweight, you're at risk for fatty liver disease as well. So what are you doing about it? What's the plan that's best for you to deal with that obesity? If you have diabetes, is it under good control? If not, then what can you do about it? Or how can we help you make that better? If you're drinking alcohol, why? I mean, we know that alcohol on top of hepatitis C is not a great combination. So do you understand really that you could be making an impact there? And do we need to get you help for that treatment? Have we vaccinated you for hepatitis A and B, making sure that we're not letting other viruses impact your liver in the future? I just think it's important to go back to all those things. The treatment's important. It's vital. It's going to be the backbone of all of this. But we also need to take care of these people and their livers in all other ways as well. And I think that this needs to be a key part of education and emphasized during their visits as they come back. What else are they doing to take great care of their liver? I look forward to these new treatments. I look forward to being able to help them. And I look forward to being able to talk to you all more about them as they become available and these new regimens unfold. Thank you very much.